Hello, Ramona. I can't shake the simplest feeling beyond the ghost. We stand on the opposite shore. Hello, Ramona. I reach through mysterious ceilings, my only hope. I look for the things I don't know. Show me where the ending goes.
Hello, everyone, and welcome to the start of the vlog. If you hear my car, it's cold. It's 33 degrees. I'm shaking like a leaf. You know, I gotta get warm. So, but today, if you hadn't seen the thumbnail and the title and stuff like that, I am doing a dedicated reading vlog for Layna. And I think this one is specifically funny because I'm going to read her favorite book of last year and one of her least favorite books of last year. And if you've joined reading sprints at all within the past like 6 months, you will know that Layna loves The Lost Girls of Willowbrook, like absolutely loves it. And you'll also know that she despises Comfort Me with Apples. And I cannot remember the author, but I have it already downloaded on my Kindle from the library. Layna is like one of my really good, close YouTube friends. We also live in the same state, so we meet up from time to time. And I just thought it would be really cool, A, to read her favorite book of the year, which is The Lost Girls of Willowbrook, but also to be kind of like a smart ass with this vlog. I wanna see why she hates this book so much, because there's so many people that love Comfort Me with Apples. So I need to know. Also, Comfort Me with Apples, I believe, like on audio, like at 2x the speed, is like an hour. So I can easily get through that book. So I will update you on which book I actually start with in the future. Right now, I'm on my way to my chiropractor appointment. This is actually my first appointment, which I'm really, really excited about. I've always been like sort of fascinated with like chiropractors and like, you know, how that works and stuff like that. And like over time, I'm starting to realize like, you know, I'm getting old, but I've realized that there are a few small minor issues that I'm having, and I really want to kind of look into chiropractic. Is that the name?
I have no idea. You know, I'm just the southern hick that doesn't know how to say or read anything.
But I've had like a few smaller issues. There are some things in my family's like health history that I'm really concerned with that I would like to get like just checked over, just more of a consultation. But I've also talked to a few of my friends, one of them being my coworker and one of them being Gwen, and they both recommend that I go see a chiropractor because it is like life-changing for them. And so I'm really curious to see. I mean, in worst case scenario, if I don't need it, then that's great. So wish me luck. I will give you guys all the updates after my appointment. It is currently 7 o'clock at night. Reading sprints start in an hour. My chiropractor appointment went very, very well. Like, I'm so pleased. I was very impressed with the doctor, very knowledgeable. You could truly tell that he was wanting to hear my concerns and wanting to fix and prevent them. But he also like told me things that I need to do in order to improve. So I'm very excited. I actually go back this Saturday for a full adjustment, which I'm very, very excited about. I don't really have like a tripod right now. I don't really have you guys set up on a tripod. You're literally standing on my like Stanley Cup dupe. So hopefully this angle works. I can't remember if I mentioned this like in the beginning of this video, but I woke up and this eye, it actually looks a lot better, but my eye is just so like irritated and red. So that is why we are rocking the four eyes today. I'm actually doing reading sprints with Kelsey from Essentially Booked tonight, and I told her, I said I might have to do reading sprints with sunglasses on because just like the lights are just too much for me. Speaking of lights, I actually got new smart bulbs. I actually have one in the lamp right behind me. The reason why I wanted that was I wanted to like set like ambient background for reading sprints, but having a slight issue. I'm wondering if it shows up on camera. So Alexa, turn the lights purple.
Okay.
See, it doesn't do it here, but this is my screen for when I do reading sprints, but when I do it, I look like a character from The Simpsons. So I guess I just need to like toy around with the settings with my webcam. It's not as bad with the webcam on my MacBook, but I don't know. But yeah, I'm just literally falling apart right here. So sorry for my appearance, but I'm not putting a makeup on with my eyes like this. I did a little bit of like some like planning with like YouTube and stuff like that. So I have about an hour before reading sprint starts. I think I'm going to go ahead and start The Lost Girls of Willowbrook. I did not get any reading in during the day. Literally after I got home after the chiropractor and running a few errands, I literally just laid down because my eye was killing me so bad. I know Gwen just recently read this book and she said it kind of made her a little like, I don't know, like a little bit down after reading it. So I'm going to inspire myself with my Be Happy bookmark. Oh, I'm so sorry. I didn't even tell you like what this book is about. So obviously it's Layna's favorite book. Layna works in like the mental health field, and one of her favorite things that she loves in books that she's discovered is like asylums. And so this is like in like the 1970s, I think. And it's about a girl named Sage and like her twin sister, who she thought was died at a young age. She realizes that that's not the case. Her parents sent her twin sister Rosemary off to like this like school. And so she goes to try to find her sister, and then come to find out it's not really a school. It's a like asylum basically for any, like a, I've heard it's like kind of like a dumping ground for anyone that has any sort of like issues and things like that. So anyways, Rosemary had actually escaped the place, and now that Sage is there and they're identical twins, they think she is actually Rosemary, so they lock her up. So yeah, I've heard this is kind of a tough read, but I'm really excited to read it.
Alrighty, we are, oh, there went my camera. There I am. Okay. Hello, welcome everyone to Monday Night Reading Sprint. Of like who you are, what you're reading, your channel, all that jazz.
Yep, so I'm Kelsey and I'm fairly new to the BookTube world. I was just telling Jesse I was on Bookstagram for forever. So Essentially Booked both platforms. And then I am reading Liar, Dreamer, Thief tonight.
Dedicated video for Layna from Layna's Bookshelves. And so I am reading her favorite book of the year, which is The Lost Girls of Willowbrook. And then I'm also reading her worst book, one of her worst books of the year, which is Comfort Me with Apples.
I loved it, so.
Yeah, I feel like it's always like 50-50.
I want to stay here with you. All that we have is each other now. I promise I won't be your side.
You look so cool.
I said I feel cool. I feel like a celebrity who wears glasses inside.
All that we have is each other now. I promise you won't leave my side. Tell me why.
I have a book to pick up for Jessica stuff.
I swear that I'll stay here with you.
Thank you.
So, sorry for the weird lighting. I don't know where my tripod went. So, I have you sitting on my bookshelves. But I wanted to let you guys know that I finished The Lost Girls of Willowbrook. And I can't remember if I gave a general synopsis of what this is. But this is about a woman named Sage. She's actually like 16, I believe. And 6 years ago, she thought her twin sister Rosemary had died, and this is set in the 1970s, that she had died from pneumonia. And when in reality, she's finding out that her sister Rosemary was sent to this Willowbrook School Institute. Rosemary does have a few issues and things like that. And so her parents, not knowing what to do, they sent her away to this Willowbrook School. Sage is under the impression that this is like a kind of like a boarding school where Rosemary is getting still like an education and things like that. So without telling anyone, she decides to take a bus to Willowbrook. Also, she had just found out that Rosemary is missing, that she had ran away. Nobody knows where she's at, and like she had ran away. So finding out that your twin sister, who you thought was dead for 6 years, is actually alive, Sage decides to take a trip. And when she gets there, because they're twins, they think she is Rosemary. And of course she's like, no, my name is Sage. I'm her twin sister. I'm here to look for her. And they're like, okay, yeah, okay, Rosemary. Because apparently Rosemary would say things like she's Sage, her twin sister. And so they don't believe her. She doesn't have an ID. She kind of lost all of her belongings. Yeah, and that's where the story kind of takes off. This book was so horrific, and I can see why Layna likes this book so much, because like I said, Layna does work in the mental health field, and so she loves like asylum type books, and she's really gotten into her like historical fiction, even though this is like set in the 1970s. But the patients are treated so horrible. Like, there's people with like missing limbs and open wounds, and like they're not being treated properly. This is clearly not a school. It is like literally like an asylum. And they're like, they don't take showers. There's urine and feces and blood all over the place. And it's just like the worst living conditions ever. It kind of gave me anxiety. Like, I kind of knew going into this, because hearing Layna and a few other people talking about this book, I kind of knew like that, like to expect that. So this book was very, very shocking, and it made me like, it was kind of like a survival type game. Like, is she gonna get out? Is she gonna find her sister? But I feel like this book shifted a little bit and went into like a mystery, which I'm not gonna get into because I feel like it kind of like spoils a few things. And I really started to like, I felt like this book was a 4-star book for me, but when it shifted to the mystery, that's when I really, really enjoyed the book. You know, the person behind the mystery and everything was not shocking at all. But I think it's just because like I do read a lot of like mystery thrillers. So if that is a genre that you don't read but you like historical fiction, I think you would be really, really shocked at the end. Like, I can see this being like very, very shocking. Although the person that was behind a few things was not very shocking, I think the reasoning or like the backstory behind it is what really shocked me. I actually messaged Layna and I was like, I feel like this book is like a 4.5, but the more I keep sitting with it, and even as I'm talking to the camera right now, like I feel like this is a 5-star read, and I don't do half stars anymore. So I'm gonna give it 5 stars. So Layna, this was such a good one, and I can see why this is your favorite book of the year last year. Definitely worth reading if you like historical fiction, even if you like mystery thrillers. This one's really good, and honestly, I could not tell it was in the 1970s for like a good portion of the time. Like, there's phone numbers and things like that that's mentioned. So I definitely feel like this is worth the read, and I might pick up my own copy, to be honest. So with that in mind, we have one last book for this vlog, and it is Comfort Me with Apples. I literally have no idea what this book is about. I just know Layna said,
but here's a list of things that take roughly an hour that I feel like would be a more enjoyable time than reading this book. Going to the gyno, standing in line at the DMV, shoveling snow, getting a root canal. This book was so bad and such a waste of time.
I'm nervous, but I don't know what this book is about. And I looked at the audiobook and I can literally finish it in an hour. So I think I'm going to go to bed and I'm going to start this book. I already have it on my Kindle. I have the audiobook ready. I'm going to try and knock it out. So wish me luck, but I will have an update in the morning. Hello. It has actually been a few days later, so I apologize. I was actually editing my video over on my computer and I realized I never updated you anything about Comfort Me with Apples. So Comfort Me with Apples, unfortunately, is going to be a one-star read for me. Layna, you were right. This book was bad, like really, really bad. I know that this book is meant for some readers, but for me, this was just not a book that I enjoyed. So reading this book, I was confused but also like theorizing like a bunch of different things, and once you get to the end and realize what's happening and like the true meaning behind everything and like the references, it's not something I like in books like at all. So I get that this does work for some people, but it doesn't for me. I would say probably my favorite thing about the book is that it is so short. Literally, if you can read at 2x the speed as an audiobook, you can get this done in an hour. Unfortunately, this book was just not good, in my opinion. Now, I know there are some people that loved it. Not me. This book is about a woman who lives in this perfect town, in this perfect house, and how she's so perfect. And then she starts suspecting things are not what they seem to be, and that she's questioning her husband and like what he's doing, and also there's this basement that she's not allowed to go down to, and that's pretty much all you need to know. After I read it, I was like, okay, this is what I think it is. So I started looking at other like Goodread like reviews, and my suspicions were correct. And I, again, it's something that I don't like in books, and I don't, it's just not my preferred reading taste, respectfully. So I would tell you what it is, but it is like kind of a major spoiler. So unfortunately, it's not for me. Maybe if you have an hour to kill, you can read it. But to me, I think it's worth passing. Anyways, thank you guys so much for watching this video. I'm going to have Layna's information down in the description box for you to go check out. Make sure you go follow her and give this video a thumbs up and subscribe so you don't miss out on any other future vlogs. And I will see you guys in the next one. Bye.